let us be seekers of the truth. We should not let the anything blind us from the truth, okay? I will show you something which about Prophet Job. Okay?
Prophet Job?
Yeah. Now there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord. And Satan also came among them. The Lord said to Satan, from where have you come? And Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro on the earth, and from walking up and down on it. And the Lord said to Satan, have you considered my servant Job? That there's none like him, okay, on the earth, a blameless and upright man, who fears God and turns away from evil. Then Satan answered the Lord and said, does Job fear God for no reason? Have you not put a hedge around him and his house and all that he has on every side? You have blessed the work of his hands, and his position have increased in the land, but stretch out. So Satan is telling God what to do, yeah? But listen to this, yeah? Sorry, German. But stretch out your hand and touch all that he has, and he will curse you to your face. Okay, so Satan is saying, he will curse
God, that's right. If he takes away what Job has,
Job will change.
Job will curse you.
Yeah, Job will change. Okay. So now watch this. Okay? I don't want this one to go away. Okay? Okay, here again. Okay. And the Lord said to Satan, have you considered my servant Job, that there is none like him on the earth, a blameless and upright man, who fears God and turns away from evil? He still holds fast his integrity. Although you incited me and guessed him to destroy him without a reason. So God said to Satan, you incite me to destroy Job without a reason. So Satan influenced God to test who? Job. But you just said me Satan God that no one influenced God. You see what I'm saying? That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, because you asked something which is a good question. I hope you're sincere. Likewise, I'll try to be sincere, inshallah. Allah mentioned in the Quran, Waylun, woe to those who write something, and they say that's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you look to Germany, yeah? When you look to the Prophet of God in the Bible, and the Prophet of God in the Quran, you know what Allah said in the Quran? Maybe I know. Allah said in the Quran, Job, Satan tried to test him. But you know what he said? He was very patient with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, when he wants to complain, his wife doesn't complain.
So you believe the version of Job that's in the Quran rather than the version
because it makes more sense. Because Jesus told me no one should influence God. Allah in the Quran never mentioned that Satan influenced him to... And listen to this, yeah, without a reason. That's oppression.
That's right.
So does God oppress his people? Especially the Israelites.
He does, that's right.
Without a reason.
He tries us.
Without a reason.
Without a reason.
Yeah.
Well, it's to try our faith.
Yeah, but he said without a reason, yeah. He said, Satan, you incited me to destroy Job without a reason.
That's right. Job didn't do nothing wrong.
That's oppression. Imagine how
God is God, isn't it? How
can God answer your question?
No, he didn't, because I asked him why in the Quran it says Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, prophethood should be with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And how did Ishmael come into prophethood?
Because in that verse, if you take it out, clearly Allah said that Allah will be given the prophethood to the offspring of Abraham. Offspring of who? Abraham. Okay?
Yeah, but Abraham had 20 children.
No, him.
It was a child of promise.
Before we go to Abraham, we're not talking about Abraham. Now Allah, because you quote the verse, correct? So if you quote the verse, you have to quote it correctly. Allah said the prophet would be given to the offspring of Abraham. It's Ishmael.
Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
No. This is not a verse you're talking about. Because there's a verse Allah said will be given to the offspring of Noah and Abraham. Okay, Noah and Abraham. So now is Ishmael the offspring of Abraham? Yes, according to Quran. Now in the Quran clearly said about Ismail, wa kana rasul al-nabiyya, and Ismail was a messenger of Allah and a prophet of Allah. See what I'm saying? Is that clear? Okay. Of course. But he seems like a wise man, inshallah. What I'm saying, look. Are you? I don't know, but I'm just going to ask, are you coming from the angle of Hebrew Israelite thing?
That's right.
Okay. Allah mentioned the Quran. Ya Bani Israel, وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةِ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَأَنِّي فَضَّلْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. Oh, the Israelites. Allah addressing the Israelites. Remember my favor upon you. that I have bestowed you, I have bestowed my favor upon you, and I have chosen you.
Ishmael was an Israelite.
Hear me. I have favored you over the other nations.
That's right.
And Allah favored the Israelites because why? They follow God's teaching,
that's right,
and there was many prophets among them.
That's right.
But there's a condition. Allah doesn't favor you because you're born as a black or white. No, because you follow His teaching. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran on the Bible that there will be a prophet like Moses, okay, and Allah wants to test the people, because some people, they follow God as long as the prophet is from their nation, from their tribe. If a prophet is not from their tribe, they don't follow that prophet. So God is testing the people. Are you following my teaching because someone from your country, or you following my teaching because you believe I am God? That's what Allah tells the Israelites by bringing the last prophet from the Arabs. And are you aware that in the Old Testament, there is a prophecy about Prophet Muhammad?
I don't believe it.
Okay, I will show you. You go do your research, but I will show you this one. Isaiah 42. I will show you King James 1. Okay? 1 minute. Too many zip in this suitcase. Confusion. Okay. I will let you to think. Tell me what you think about this. Okay? This Isaiah 42, okay? The servant comes to glorify the Lord. Behold, my servant whom I uphold, my elect one, in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the Gentiles. Who are the Gentiles?
All the nations that are not Israelites.
They're not Israelites, okay. So these servants coming to the Gentiles.
So why did God go to the Gentiles? Why did he go to an Arab nation?
Yeah, why God? You can't tell what God to do.
Yeah, I know, but why would he do that?
Finished. Yeah.
Why would he do it?
What do you mean, why? Look, he will bring forth justice to the Gentiles. He will not cry out nor raise his voice. Okay? I want to focus on the main point here. Watch this. Yeah. Let the wilderness and its cities lift up their voice. The villages that Kedah inhabits, let the inhabitants of Selah sing it. Do you know what's Kedah?
No.
Okay. You go to Genesis 25:13 and it tell you who is Kedah. And these were the names of the sons of Ishmael, by their names according to their generations. The firstborn of Ishmael, Nabiot. Then who? Kedah. So this prophecy speaking precisely, specifically about a person, also about a name. If you go to Selah and you Google it, a mountain of Selah is known to be in Saudi, more specifically in Medina. So this prophecy I spoke to Christians, I spoke to Hebrew Israelites. No one can give me an answer. This prophecy, there's two things about it. Either is a false prophet because no one fulfilled this prophecy except Prophet Muhammad. So if you don't accept Prophet Muhammad, about Prophet Muhammad, you have to accept that Isaac is a false prophet. If you accept that prophecy is true, then does it not fit no one except Prophet Muhammad.
I have to do some more research.
No worries, I told you. All right, bro? It was nice talking to you. Look out to yourself. Take care. Yeah, you had questions about what Allah chosen.
That was his question.
About the Ismail.
Yeah.
Khalas, inshallah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, look what Allah said. Allah said, لَا يُسْأَلْ عَمَّا يَفْعَلْ وَهُمْ يُسْأَلُونَ. You don't ask Allah what He does, but Allah will ask you. That's His kingdom. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, because we believe prophethood, the first thing Allah chooses people. However, as I told you, Allah wants to test the people. Because the Israelites, they were following a prophet. Allah, many prophets are from the Israelites. We know that, okay? Without any doubt, Allah mentioned that, okay? However, Allah wants to test them. Are you following these prophets because they are from you people, or are you following them because you believe in me, in God? So Allah wants to test you. Let me bring a prophet from another nation, and I see if you're going to believe in him, because that prophet is coming from me.